and good morning. We are so excited that you can be with us today, as well as so many of our Volusia County law enforcement officers. We have police chiefs. We have folks from the Sheriff's Department. We have Senator Tom Wright. We have head of emergency management, Sheriff Chitwood. We're very, very excited that all of you are here to highlight such an important issue with us today. As you know, my name is Ashley Moody. I'm the Attorney General of the best state in the nation. Proud to be so, and one of my favorite things to do is to help law enforcement do their jobs and help them in any way that I can in this position. It is no shock to those of you that are here with us and those who may be watching, we are in the middle of a spring break season in Florida. And the state has done so much proactively to supplement resources and make sure we are prepared for all that comes with spring break. And spring break is a fabulous thing for Florida. We know that Americans, students, adults flock to our Florida beaches. We love this about Florida. It's what makes us unique. In fact, I could probably ask everybody up here, as a teenager or a kid or a student, did you participate in spring break in Florida? Raise your hand. Okay, so I did too. So this spring break in Florida can create a lasting lifetime memory in a positive way. We also know that because millions will come to Florida, whether it's seeking a break from scholastic studies or seeking a break from the harsh weather up north, they will come here, and we know because of that and so many coming here, we lead the nation for those who overdose while on vacation. And that is a stat that we want to change. And it is also the reason that brings us all together today, because this is something that sometimes gets lost in the discussion when we're talking about how to secure our beaches and how to make sure we're reducing crime. But somewhere in all of these discussions, we lose sight of the fact that many equate spring break with drug use, and we have got to stop that because we now know that so many illicit substances contain a lethal dose of fentanyl. And that is one of the reasons that we have been seeing such a rapid escalation in overdose rates. We know last year in 2023, 112,000 people in this nation overdosed and died from drug use. And I want to put that in perspective, because I think what happens is when we start hearing these numbers, you know, when we hear another large number the next year, we're like, oh, okay, well, we last year it was something similar. No, 112,000 people, to put that in perspective, when Nancy Reagan first started the Just Say No campaign, we lost just over 3,000 people nationwide, and we considered that to be a crisis. We now lose 112,000 in 1 year nationwide. So we are in the midst of an overdose crisis in the U.S. That is in large part because the abundant supply and surge of fentanyl being pushed into this country. Florida is not immune to that. Fentanyl is making its way into Florida and in every illicit substance that you can think of. And many times people will ingest an illicit substance having no idea that there is a lethal dose of fentanyl. In fact, just this year again, we saw in fake pills that are seized by the DEA, 7 out of 10 of those pills have a lethal dose of fentanyl. Last year, that was 6 out of 10. So even in those numbers, we're still seeing an escalation of the lethal dose of fentanyl in drugs. Now, when I say fake pills, think about this. This is what kids are getting off the internet. They're getting from their friends at school. Many times they think it's Adderall or Xanax, things that are prescribed or illicit, but they may not believe have fentanyl. They're taking them from their friends, and many children, young adults, are dying. We know in Florida we are doing everything in our power to get our arms around the opioid epidemic and the fentanyl crisis. I just delivered what I see as positive signs that what we are doing and the resources that we're committed to implementing are working, and that ranges from our law enforcement efforts being very aggressive, going after these poison peddlers, putting them behind bars, keeping them separated from our communities, but also, and not losing sight of, the community recovery programs, because if you have ever had a problem with drugs, if you have ever been addicted to drugs, now is the time to get help, because I've just said one pill can kill. And we're quickly moving from one pill can kill to one pill can kill, will kill. And so we have got to get through to our community members. If you're struggling with addiction, go to treatmentnavigator.org right now. It will connect you with a organization, whether that's inpatient or outpatient, that can help you. It's never been more important. You can also go to our webpage where we launched the One Pill Can Kill campaign, doseofrealityfl.com, and that has an abundance of resources of how you can get help. And lastly, we're focusing on Narcan and the generic drug naloxone, which is a tool that has been used by medical professionals, emergency responders, and law enforcement to help those who may have overdosed have a fighting chance at recovering to go on to a successful and healthy life. This has been a remarkable tool. It has truly been beneficial in our efforts. My office launched a Helping Heroes program, which partners with Walmart around the state. Agencies that sign up can go right into a Walmart store, show that they are law enforcement, and get a resupply of Narcan. And we know during spring break, this tool will be used. We know that law enforcement and other emergency responders will use this, and it is so important that they have access to this, ready access, ready to a resupply. And we're grateful to Walmart for partnering with our Helping Heroes program. Again, I want to remind everyone that is here from out of state or in state, celebrating during spring break, celebrating this time of the year. We welcome that in Florida. We want this to be a positive experience. So many of us have such fond memories and pleasant experiences from our younger days. But we don't want what is intended to be a memorable experience to be tragic. And we have seen that happen time and time again. I would tell you that those standing with me today, for every story they have where they can remember in their youth where there was something positive that came from spring break, unfortunately, they can also tell you in these roles that they're serving, they've seen the other side, the dark side of spring break, especially as it relates to drug misuse and overdose. And so I'm very excited to announce today that the law enforcement agencies standing with me, effective immediately, have become a part of the Helping Heroes program. And we're so grateful to them for taking part. Volusia County Sheriff's Office, DeLand Police Department, Daytona Police Department, Ormond Beach Police Department, Ponce Inlet Police Department, and South Daytona Police Department are now officially part of the Helping Heroes program. And we know this will go a long way to saving lives during spring break and throughout the rest of the year as Florida successfully combats this drug overdose crisis. And I will say, congratulations to all those standing with me today. Volusia County has seen a drastic decrease in their opioid overdose rates. And I truly believe that is because of the combination of working together, law enforcement, but not losing sight of the recovery efforts and the emergency response efforts to save lives. It all goes hand in hand. Our fentanyl within Volusia County, our fentanyl deaths, overdose have decreased slightly, not to the extent of opioids in general, but we are on a positive track here, just as we are in Florida. And that is great news for this state who wants to stay the state that attracts everyone from all over the nation to our beaches, to our cities. We know we break records every year in tourism. We do not want that to stop. And we also want folks to know that when you come here, you will be safe. We'll be proactive to make sure we're not only securing and fortifying our beaches, but that we're offering help to those who are struggling and warning those who may associate spring break with using illicit substances. That could be the last time you use illicit substances. So appreciate you being here with us today for this exciting announcement about our joint efforts, but to also get the word out to community members about having a safe spring break. It's so important. And without further ado, I will turn it over to a man who needs no introduction, Sheriff Chitwood.
Thank you, Madam Attorney General. I did not grow up in Florida, and during spring break, it was normally a snowball fight was going on from up north at that time of year. I want to thank the Attorney General because since she has been elected, she has been the tip of the spear for fighting the opioid and fentanyl crisis in the state of Florida. She was the first, I think, Attorney General to put a task force together with Sheriff Lima appointing it to try to tackle this thing in the very beginning. So thank you. One of the things that the Attorney General hit on is, yeah, it's spring break, and we have underage folks in town. And what do underage folks do when they're looking to buy a party drug? They go to the black market. And the problem with the black market is, as the Attorney General mentioned, and all of us in this room can testify to, when we serve search warrants on these drug dens, we recover pill presses. Those pill presses are pressing pills to look like popular party drugs, Adderall, Xanax, MDA, and they're 100% fentanyl. And that's the message we need to get out to parents, is you got to educate your children. They think they're buying this stuff off the street or they're buying it from a classmate, therefore it's good stuff. In reality, it's laced with fentanyl. We saw we had the kid from recently from Polk County, armed with a gun, 75 grams of marijuana, selling it on the beach to spring breakers. The very next day, the first car stop we make is an adult on the beach with trafficking amounts of meth inside of the car. What was he here for? They're here to sell to the kids. And that stuff that they're buying on the street is laced with fentanyl. And I'll close with this. As we now run our own juvenile assessment center, and any kid that's court ordered to provide a urine sample, what we find is these kids are buying THC vapes on the black market. That's not bad enough. But their urine tests are coming back with fentanyl, meth, PCP, and heroin in it. And the kids aren't talking to law enforcement, they're talking to drug counselors. So that's the fear, that's why I'm so glad the Attorney General is here, because they think they're buying one thing, and they're ingesting something totally different. And that one time is what can end their lives. So thank you, Madam Attorney General.
And now we're gonna have Kevin Captain, who's head of emergency management, share a few words.
Thank you. Thank you, Attorney General Moody. I'm Kevin Captain, Volusia County EMS Chief. On behalf of Volusia County EMS and the countless first responders from Volusia County and throughout the state of Florida, we are grateful for the Helping Emergency Responders Obtain Support, or HEROES, program. These doses of naloxone literally save lives. In calendar year 2023, our agency, Volusia County EMS, was involved in almost 1,000 cases in which naloxone was administered and saved those lives. This medication gives people a second chance at life. Spring break is more dangerous today than it ever was before because of what we're talking about that's on the black market. You don't know what's out there. And especially fentanyl and the fentanyl analogs that are out there, they can be up to 100 times more potent than the legitimate medication. The HEROES program helps us obtain this vital, life-saving medication. The program ensures that we have naloxone stocked and ready to give intravenously or intranasally. Thousands of patients who are emergently transported and treated with naloxone are alive today with their families. They're saved. And thankfully, patients will continue to be treated promptly and saved with this medication. So we thank Attorney General Ashley Moody for her conscientious efforts with this program, with the HEROES program, the Florida Department of Health, the Florida Department of Children and Families, and all of the many first responders who are helping to combat this nationwide opioid epidemic. Spring break is upon us. Be safe. Stay away from opioids. You don't know what's in them. We're always here to respond. And thanks to the HEROES program, we have naloxone ready to give. But remember, your life is far too important than a quick high. Please use good judgment. Thank you. Karen.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you, Attorney General. I appreciate the opportunity to share a little bit about the Volusia Recovery Alliance. We are a 501c3 organization that is CAPRIS accredited. We're the number four in the state to achieve that. But we are in place to help families and the person struggling with substance use to get the resources they need to enter into recovery and to maintain recovery. The Department of Children and Families made us, several years ago, towards the end of 21, we started to have free Narcan come down from the Department of Children and Families. And in that time through today, we've given out more than 18,000 Narcan kits with reports of 197 lives saved from our Narcan distribution. That's not to say other entities throughout Volusia County are doing similar work with handing out Narcan, but we have formalized training programs to help people learn how to use it. We have many programs in place to help families as well as the person struggling to stay and get into recovery. And so we're very proud of that. We can't do this without our community partners. We partner greatly with law enforcement, EMS, throughout the whole county. I'm happy to say we have a contract to help first responders as well to get the resources that they need. One of my staff, his name is Rhino. He goes by Rhino. His name is Ryan Foster. He was supposed to be here this morning, but he's a dad, and his kids got sick, and he got sick. So I'll tell a little bit of Rhino's story. He was Narcaned 18 times during his active use. Often he didn't seek out fentanyl, but the heroin that he was using was tainted with it. And so the last time he was Narcaned, he like went, wow, I really need to stop. And so he went into treatment, and he's been in recovery ever since. He's now got over 3 years of recovery. He's one of my staff that heads up a dad's program that we have, and he is truly making a difference in our community. You know, all of my staff are people in recovery. The best weapon is the recovering person. I've been in recovery 41 years, and I used cocaine in my active addiction. I was a healthcare professional that I sank my career as a result of my drug use, and I'm just so committed to getting the message out that recovery is possible and it should be expected. And we are here to help people in Volusia County with whatever they need for recovery resources. So I'm so happy to be here. I'm so happy and grateful for our community partnerships. Sheriff Chitwood has been one of our biggest partners and has opened doors for us that we would never have been able to achieve. Stigma is the biggest barrier against asking for help. And so we're committed to reducing stigma, and part of the way we do that is to show up with our friends in law enforcement. So thank you so much. And I really appreciate all the work that you're doing so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And first let me say thank you to Senator Wright, who has always advocated in Tallahassee for our first responders, for the resources they need to combat this opioid epidemic. We're grateful for you and for all your efforts, and grateful for those like the director here, Director Schrapik, who struggled with addiction, and after putting in the hard work and recovering, said, I would like to use my struggles to help others. Time and time again, I have met people who have finally, after years, struggled with addiction, said, I want to be a better person. I want to be there for my family. I want to offer my difficulties to others as a way to show that you can overcome such a difficult time in your life, such a personal struggle. And I've seen time and time again it have remarkable effects. And those who had struggled with addiction, not only are they now present and fully involved in their families' lives, and so that family unit will be forever better off because that person put in the work, but they go on to not only be a positive impact in their communities, but I would dare say they've saved lives, because they chose to get help. And so if anything that we've said today has moved you or has said, I'm ready to do this, not just because I'm concerned for my own safety because of the prevalence of fentanyl in the United States and in Florida and these illicit substances, because I want to be a positive influence in my family and my community, and I know that I can do that. Go again to treatmentatlas.org. You can find a program like Volusia Recovery Alliance where you can get help. I would urge you to do that. That is the only way we will pull the state out of this crisis. So again, thank you for being here with us as we warn not just Floridians, but those who have come to Florida to be a part of the spring break festivities. We want people to do that. We think it is a great thing for our state. We think it attracts many people to all that Florida has to offer, but we want them to be safe, and that's what today is all about. We'd be happy, any of us here, I assume, would be happy to take any questions.
Is there an education piece that comes after, say, you run into someone who's overdosing, you help them, what happens next to make sure they get the
So, you know, I want to also give credit to First Lady DeSantis, and Governor DeSantis. This has also been one of their top priorities. One of the things we have highlighted and pushed in the state that it can't be someone is overdosing, we save them, we bring them to a hospital, and then that's the end of it. Because that will just keep happening, and we will never get that person to a point where we're not going to have to keep bringing them back. And so we have encouraged the kind of, we'll call it a warm handoff, where you go from an emergency situation to an organization that can help you with the resources to maintain sobriety, to maintain, you know, taking yourself out of that cycle of drug use and drug abuse. And so that generally will be offered if you go to an emergency room and you have overdose. But I know that the law enforcement agencies and the first responders that engage with those who have overdosed also have that information. That's why you heard Director Shafik say they work with law enforcement to make sure they're educated, that they know to give that information over, and that folks that have experienced that know where to go and where they can get help.
Attorney
yes, sir.
General, I know spring break all over Florida. You're here in Daytona today. Is this program being done around other spring break areas, or has there been a case maybe in Volusia County that makes you being here a priority to deliver this to law enforcement in the area?
Well, we've been working with law enforcement for some time now. As you heard, I led a statewide opioid task force to examine ways we could bring down the overdose death rate here in Florida. There were many recommendations. Our great legislative leaders and our governor have followed up on those and given the resources to the state to help us do that. And we're seeing some positive signs from those efforts, especially as it compares to the national rates of overdose. But as you know, in Florida, our leadership here is very proactive. So when we suspect or have seen crime trends, or we have seen trends that may affect the health and safety of our citizens, we're very proactive. So prior to spring break starting, you heard a rollout that we were going to send additional state officers around the state to different beaches that may have had crime trends that showed they needed help during this time of spring break. We also know that in the second quarter of every year, we do see a spike in overdose rates. That's probably not a coincidence that it is also the spring break time when we have so many people coming in here. You heard me say earlier that a study has shown that Florida leads the nation. If you are going to die on vacation of overdose, Florida is the lead state for that. We are also the leading state for tourism. So those numbers are not shocking, but we're proactive. And so as we knew that spring break was upon us, as you know, I issued some warnings as to drug use. We want to make sure people know that now 7 out of 10 pills seized, these fake pills, have an illicit or a lethal dose of fentanyl. And we're making sure that our law enforcement partners and emergency response personnel around the state are ready to go. They know where they can get resupplied on Narcan, and that they know about the resources available to them. Again, this is not a one event thing where we're going to show up and warn in one area and we're going to take care of the problem. This is a problem that, as I started off this conference talking about, is pervasive nationwide. We have done everything we can do in pushing back on some of the policies at our border that have led to fentanyl coming into this country, both in court, both in policy discussions. We've been very vocal here in Florida that that is unacceptable, and it's untenable to states like us where this deadly, brutal drug gets dumped. And where people are coming and selling this drug, it puts a lot on our law enforcement efforts. We expect a lot of them because of that overwhelming supply of fentanyl. But the reality is that is what we are up against now. We have a border that is wide open, fentanyl flooding into this country, into our state. And it is remarkable that we have been able to stem those escalating numbers as much as we have, contrary to the national trends. A lot of that is due to the men and women standing up here with me today and their efforts. But we are a proactive state. So as you heard Governor DeSantis say, we're going to roll out additional state personnel to our cities and ahead of spring break. We also put out warnings about drug use. We're very proactive, and we will remain that way, not just during spring break. As you know, we're a law and order state, and we'll keep pounding that message to make sure not just Floridians know that, but the people that might think to come to the state know that.
You alluded to it a little bit. I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
You alluded a little bit, like, your message to people who see this as an opportunity to come in here. Maybe they're upping their production because all these people coming into the area. What is your message to those people accused of dealing those drugs?
Yeah, you heard Sheriff Chitwood say he has seen people descend upon our beaches with drugs in tow to take advantage of what some may see as a party-like atmosphere. You know, Florida has been very clear. We do not backpedal from strong law enforcement efforts. Spring break is no different. If you're coming here with the intention of committing a crime or selling drugs that may harm our citizens, you have a lot of folks that wear badges that are going to be fighting as hard as they can against you. Truly, and I think that message resounds not only within Florida, but to those outside of Florida, especially criminals. You've heard it. They've heard the word. They've gotten the word. Many will avoid Florida. I would suggest that you do. If you are thinking of coming here with a criminal intent, think twice. We back our law enforcement that go after the bad guys that want to do harm to those that have come here to make lifetime memories and enjoy all that Florida has to offer. We want to make sure that is what remains true. That is what keeps our state strong and safe and attractive to so many. And I'm just thankful we have guys and gals like this that are willing to do these important, dangerous, courageous jobs that keeps Florida such a strong and safe state. Thank you so much.